He enjoys music, astronomy, quotations, and poetry. His one of the favorite quotes is, "We are always preparing to live, but never living." We are highly privileged, sir, to have you with us today. I would like, sir, to share his words of blessings on all of us.
Thank you, dear Simar. And I think you are a student.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Because Anchal and Simar appear to me like students. Other appear to me like faculty. But sometimes the conclusion becomes wrong because nowadays face does not reflect the exact situation. And many faculty appear like students and many students appear like faculty. Fine. So I'm very happy to be with you all. And thank you very much for giving me opportunity to be with you all in this wonderful afternoon and on this special occasion of Teachers' Day. I know that ICFI should be around 25 to 26 years old institution. Because I remember because I started my banking career in 1988 and then teaching 1987, teaching career in 1989. And after 5 or 6 years, ICFI Hyderabad had come into scene. So congratulations for almost completing silver jubilee year, 25 years of existence and wonderful existence. And once upon a time, I think one Mr. Panduranga Rao ji and myself had some discussion long back in one conference. And yes, that time, he was also playing sheet anchor role for establishing ICFI. I think that year, maybe 1997 or so, long back. Fine. Professor Suresh Chand Sharma Saab, the director of IBS Gurgaon. Thank you very much for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to be with wonderful faculty of ICFI IBS Gurgaon. Dr. Anupama Raina ji, the deputy director of the institute. Dr. Shalini Khandelwal ji, the dean academics. Dr. Shalini ji, thank you very much. She consulted me and she contacted me in the beginning and asked to be with you all.
And you so nothing much, sir.
Happy moment for me than to agree and I'm here with you. Professor R. Venkatraman sir, Dr. Devika Vashish ji, Professor Navleen Bhatia ji, dear Anchal and Simar, and all faculty members of IBS Gurgaon. As I understand, there should be about 40 to 45 faculty members in IBS Gurgaon Center and about maybe 500 plus students, if I'm not wrong. That's fine.
One batch, yes, sir.
One batch, all right. So, greetings for this Teacher's Day. And teacher is a great word itself, teacher. And in Indian philosophy or Indian literature, a word available before the word of Acharya or Upadhyay or Pathak, you know, there used to be hierarchy earlier also. Acharya, Upacharya, Pathak. Pathak means a person who is in the beginning phase. Upacharya, Upadhyay means something like deputy or let us say associate professor kind of thing. Upadhyay, then Acharya, it means professor. But Shikshak, the word teacher, I always say to my fellow colleagues, teacher word is more weightful, having more gravity than our designations of either professor or associate professor or assistant professor. Teacher is the most weightful word. And we have to invest on daily basis. We have to do positive struggle to justify, to be called as a teacher. And that struggle has to be on daily basis. In one conference, one student asked me about 3-4 years back. That time I was working with IIM Indore as professor. he asked after my speech that why IIMs are so sought after place, why they are important. Then my simple answer was, and it still holds today, either it is IIM or IIT or MDI or ICFI, all teachers understand this, that IIMs or any institutions are not great because somebody has offered you the greatness of the institute. There, in any good institutes, in IBS Gurgaon or in MDI Gurgaon or in IIM Indore where I served or in NITI Mumbai where I served earlier, teachers, support staff and students, they have to do daily investment, daily level investment to be what they want to be. And in the process of becoming, we keep growing because there's nothing like to be, because only becoming is available to us. Means there is no perfect past tense in the process of growth. It is always present continuous tense. Generally, present continuous tense uses ing, becoming, happening, growing, developing, not that developed. Neither your institute or my institute is developed institute. Both institutes are developing institute. Of course, Professor Sharma Sahab also has been a very, very celebrated student of economics. I have also studied economics. In economics, we have developing and developed country kind of concept. That's fine. I salute to that concept. I'm not arguing on that. But in the process of growth, actually everything is developing. And even developed countries are developing. They have to develop. Because if developed country do not develop, if developed individual do not are not in the process of developing, if developed institutes are not in the process of developing, then the process of development will get stopped because there's nothing fixed. Heraclitus had said, even before Christ, the great philosopher had said that you cannot enter into the same river twice because everything is so dynamic. And even before that, Gautam Buddha had already said, and his concept later on translated in simpler language, chana chana jeevi, living every moment. That kind of approach we need to have for developing an institute. So I'm very happy, but time is very limited. I may have about 7 to 8 minutes left for me. I would just discuss in 5 or 6 points. That is point number 1, point number 2, point number 3, point number 4, point number 5, point number 6. And my point number 1 will talk about one particular issue. My point number 2 will talk about two particular issues. And so on, point number 3 will talk about three issues or three sub-issues. 4 will talk about 4 issues. 5 would talk about 5 issues. And 6 would talk about 6 issues. And I would like to summarize within 7-8 minutes. What is that one I want to talk? Point number 1, which is talking about one thing. And that one thing is wisdom. My point number 1 is wisdom. You see, we are teachers and we need to justify our designation. Whereas Google or any website can give information, Shastra can give knowledge, but only with the companionship of teachers, a student gets wisdom. And every individual has got duty. Once I am born as a human being, it is my duty to be wise. It is my duty to struggle to attain wisdom. And this information to knowledge to wisdom, how these are helped through three mechanism? For information, I can search any kind of website. For knowledge, I can go to Shastra or profound books. But for wisdom, you have to come to teachers. Surprisingly, when new millennium entered, you know, we have witnessed new millennium, we all sitting here, because when it was 1st January 2001, new millennium started. Of course, magazines, they started saying that on the 1st January 2000 only new millennium entered, because they had to sell their magazines, etc. So they invented new millennium beginning 1 year in advance. Anyway, so when new millennium entered, new year also entered, new decade also entered, and new century also entered. That was 1st January 2001. And in two very celebrated magazines, a special issue, they were talking about various issues. What would be the shape and size and the color and the painting of the new millennium? And there was a talk about, a discussion about teachers. And it was concluded by some thinkers at that point of time that classroom teachers would be subjected to museum in future. Fine. That was a statement given by some thinkers, some writers in very, very powerful and coveted magazines. Then again, debate started on that how this can be written. And especially teachers like us also raised our voice. And later on, a corrigendum was also published by the same magazine. I am talking about India Today and Business Today. And they said that classroom teachers can never be subjected to museum. Actually, what happens in euphoria, they had said it, that everything can be taken care by the medium of instruction. And teacher living in the physical body may not be needed. But completely, this is wrong. Because wisdom can come only through companionship with teachers. Tulsidas has written, Tat swarg apvarg sukh dhariya tula ik ang, tul na tahi sakal mili, jo sukh lav satsang. That satsang means right companionship, right kind of, let us say, friendship, or getting a right teacher. It gives enormous joy, and that joy cannot be achieved. Neither that kind of joy can neither be achieved in heaven nor can be achieved by liberation. Moksha bhi nahi de sakta. Apvarg means moksha and swarga means heaven. Neither heaven nor nirvana can give you that kind of joy, the joy which comes through wisdom. So point number one talks about one thing, wisdom. And please let us remind ourselves today that we are not only an entity or a person who is expected to cover syllabus. We are expected, basically, your function is to cover syllabus in the role of teacher. But our role is not to cover syllabus. It is to uncover syllabus. When you complete the course, students should feel awestruck. Oh my God, I thought course is going to begin now and it has already ended. After 20 sessions have ended in one particular course, the inquisitiveness of a student should increase more and more and more. So I will fail in my duty as a teacher if I do not increase the quality of thirst of the students for knowledge. So that's why that is point number one. We can go on and on only on point number one for some more time, but I think I should go to point number two now. My point number two talks about two basic skills. And especially if I become a normal man of wisdom after acquiring qualification, but I don't get the livelihood, I don't get employment, then I cannot sustain longer with my wisdom. I need to keep my body and soul intact. So two basic skills, we should always think either in the role of a school teacher or teacher of graduation level, or even at the level of teacher of post-graduation level. And these two skills are mathematical skill and language skill. This I had learned from my grandfather, who had said to me when I was in class 6, that your mathematics is fairly good and your language is, you are fairly good in language. Language means it can be English, it can be Hindi, or it can be my colloquial language, which I speak in my home. Language skill. So when these two are there, you will walk properly. A sentence told by my grandfather to me when I was in class 6 in 1971, that two things dhyan rakhna. Then I realized later on that when mathematical sense is there, you can understand mathematics itself and also physics and also chemistry and also maybe biology. And when your language skill is intact, you can understand language itself. You can understand political science. You can understand sociology. You can understand anthropology. You can understand history. You can understand philosophy. So when these two skills are intact with students, so each of us, let us say working in MDI or working in IBS Gurgaon, it is our duty, apart from addressing the subject for which I have been appointed, we should also see that whether our students have at least basic critical level of skill or dexterity in mathematical skill and language skill or not. By saying mathematical skill, I do not mean that everybody should become mathematician. No, not at all. The world should not be full of mathematician. I'm saying mathematical understanding, mathematical skill. If I see, let us say, Qutub Minar from a distance, and I guess that angle is around 45 degree, where I see the top of Qutub Minar, then I should have a guess that 1045 is equal to 1 and angle is 45. So the distance at which I am standing from Qutub Minar, the same distance, the base will be equal to height. And that is a good estimate of height of Qutub Minar. Very simple thing. You need not to be a mathematician to understand all these, but mathematical sense has to be there. This is one. And second is language skill, because language is a means of communication invented by human being. Some of communication skill teachers, I have challenged them just humorously or out of the class, that you say that for business communication or communication, language is the skill. But I said that I would beg to differ, because language skill and communication skill is different. And language is invention of human being, but there are many other means of communication. Not only language, silence is a means of communication. Sometimes when your emotions are deep, then tears are the means of communication, or prayers are the means of communication. Sometimes you get awestruck and you feel goosebump when you are overexcited. Suppose you have reached to a summit which you wanted to reach, and you walked for miles and miles, and suddenly you feel excited. That is also a communication. Anyway, so point number two was about two things: mathematical skills and language skill. We should take care of these things. Point number three talks about three things now. And these three things are science, art, and commerce. You see, in 1973, when I was in class 8, I was asked by school whether you would like to have science or art, a clear division. And expectation of teachers and society and family was that if you claim yourself to be good student, go to science. But if you are a bit shaky about science, then only you go to art. This in 1973, the system, society, school, even teachers taught us. Fine. It took me around further 15 to 20 to 25 years to understand the difference among science, art, and commerce. You see, science is basically defining the law of nature, either physics or chemistry or biology, how the nature has been created. Out of 6 pillars of Indian philosophy, one is called Vaisheshik, which was written by Rishi Kanad, and Vaisheshik talks about chemistry of universe. So our soil, that is India, has already talked about astrophysics, or you can say astrochemistry, long, long back. And Kanad was the propounder of that. That's fine. So understanding of basic science is needed. But life without art, and especially human life without art. And what is art? Art is the subjective dimension of being. For example, raising a standard of living. Without science, we cannot raise the standard of living. But for raising a standard of life, only science will not work. Understanding will work. Artistic side, or I will say aesthetic side of life, need to be done. So I understand that science and commerce, they help to reap benefit out of the given endowments, but art helps you to know how to live. So if science and commerce are like trees, the ultimate fruition and flowering is art. And it is difficult for me to understand that how I should allow myself to die without having a basic understanding of artistic side of life, unless I have read some literature, some philosophy, some psychology, how I will allow myself to die, though I have done PhD in physics. So, like this. Similarly, the distinguishing between science, art, and commerce is like that, that science and commerce understanding of this can be compared with, it helps you to climb at the top of the mountain. But when you go to a mountain and first time you have gone there, when you see the other side of the scenery, you get awestruck. Oh, myself. Oh, my God. How much beauty is spread on the other side of mountain. And you start writing a poetry. You become a poet there. That is art. So climbing the mountain is science and commerce. But going there and enjoying the scenery is art. Similarly, planting a tree is science and commerce. But enjoying the fruition and flower of that tree is art. So that's why this point number three, we must be able to tell our students that you should choose your subject as per your interest, but you should be able to at least appreciate every subject. You may not be able to study every subject, but you must have appreciation for every subject. Otherwise, you are not a wholesome kind of person. This is point number three. Point number four talks about four basic skills which any graduate are expected to have after graduation. And this is based on various surveys done upon human resource managers, that what they expect from a graduate who is from commerce or management especially. Four things they expect. Number one, clarity of the subject they have studied. Number one. Number two, communication skills in the field of written and oral. Number three, they must have understanding of practicality. When they speak, they should not smell like book worm. They should also reflect that they have understanding of the things around. That's why teachers should also be able to address the practical side of theory and conceptual side of practice. Unless we address these two, we are not creating a full circle of knowledge dissemination. And fourth thing which is expected from a fresh graduate is poise. P-O-I-S-E. Poise means internal equilibrium. How you carry yourself. Do you feel comfortable in all situations? I'm not talking about happy-go-lucky type of person who is never serious. I'm talking about a serious person, but fully calm and quiet and serene and balanced and meditated within. So we have to also see as teacher that our students do not end up becoming a graduate as agitated personality, but they should be meditated personality. So this is point number four. Point number five talks about five things. Basically, we all, mostly the teachers here, are dealing with commerce and economics and management. And we need to do five things. We all, each individual teacher should be able to contribute. They should plan in one decade, those who are fresh. Suppose a teacher who is listening to me is only 27 or 28 years old. Then you can plan in 10 years to reach to a level. Five things we need to do. One is teaching, second is training. It is not in proper sequence, they are just 5 points. Teaching, training, research, consulting, and academic administration. And in all these five, we must have at least minimum dexterity. But except academic administration, out of remaining four, in at least any two, you need to be very good, at least, if not excellent or outstanding. Out of four, teaching, training, research, consulting, in at least two, you have to be very good, because nobody should expect you to become excellent in all dimensions. That will be too much. That will be barbarous. But out of four, academic administration, on average, if you are good, it's okay. But remaining four, two very good. And even if you are average in remaining two, does not matter. But if you are average on all four, then there is a problem with this academic career. But I think we all have joined this career out of choice, because it was your choice, my choice, because some persons cannot help themselves to become a teacher. So this is point number five. And last point, point number six talks about six factors. Point number six talks about six impurities, because only completing a degree and getting a job is not enough, but actually evolving as individual is needed. You know that Maslow had said self-actualization need, and every individual in the role of teacher or student, we need to move towards that. And Indian philosophy says that nothing you need to acquire from outside. You have become something more than required. You have acquired certain impurities, weed them out. And we talk about six impurities. Kaam, krodh, moh, lobh, matsar, ahankar. Kaam means unnecessary desire, unnecessary desire. Krodh means anger. Lobh means greed. Moh in English is infatuation. And matsar means jealousy. And ahankar means misplaced ego. These six things we have added as additional, and we have to weed them out. So basically, personality development in Indian philosophy is like deleting process and not additive process. Delete six and evolve like a human being. That I was saying, the art side of the life. We are not only talking about a standard of living, we are talking about a standard of life. And unless as a teacher, myself, I carry as a person who is a manifested model, how students will get motivated. So to give direction to students, and you know that is to, I will tell you, in the role of you being a teacher or being a parent, please remember, nobody is interested in listening your words. Everybody is interested in listening your deeds. Actually, when they are watching you, they are listening also you. So we have to also understand that teachers, they have to carry themselves properly. And sixth point says that when we are persons devoid of impurities, when we carry shining within and shining outside, students can see you and can read you as a book. So these are my points. Point number one, two, three, four, five, six. But please don't take them as preaching. We are all teachers. We have habits of preaching, of course. But actually, while saying these to you, I was reminding all these to myself also. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to be with you. I pray that all you be healthy, cheerful, creative, and keep going. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving us a real better vision.
Now, I would like to give a brief introduction about our Deputy Director placement, Dr. Anupama Raina Ma'am. Ma'am has 23 years of teaching and industry experience. She has been active as consultant, trainer, and researcher in many organizations of repute. Ma'am has many national and international publications to her credit. I would like Ma'am to share her words of wisdom with us.
Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to speak on this auspicious day. I have been listening every word what has been told by Dr. Singh, and I don't think that, you know, I need to be told anything besides that, because he touched about everything, whatever possible. He talked about communication, and sir, I am taking care of placement, so I can relate to what you talked about, you know, communication being important, acceptable, unacceptable behavior, and many other things what you talked about. So I think speaking after you would be showing light to the sun, but anyway, I have been told to speak for 3 to 4 minutes. I will do that, and I'll talk to, you know, whatever I believe in. I personally believe that, you know, a teacher is a nation builder, and some way or the other, we need to come out from our classroom. We need to come out from my own set of students and start seeing the whole nation as our classroom. You know, many times when we see something wrong happening on the roadside and we start getting into taking corrective action, I myself have been told that, you know, they're not part of your institute. They're not your own students. So why did you need to get down and, you know, teach them something? But I think unless we do not believe and seeing the whole nation as a classroom, we will not be able to make the change. Second most important thing is that, you know, we have a very, very big role to play. I mean, we're not only here to give the right knowledge, but I think the most important thing is that we need to teach students the way of life. you know, what is acceptable, what is unacceptable behavior. And, you know, today you switch on the TV, you open any media channels, you will see there is a lot of negativity around. Young kids are falling prey to addictions, they are into wrongdoings, and then you start feeling bad at the end of the day that what has happened to these young kids, and suddenly some way or the other, why are they getting into all these kind of things? Now, there the role, I personally believe in the role of the teacher comes in, that the way, the day you enter into a classroom, maybe you start from a kindergarten, some way or the other, we do not talk about the value system. We do not talk about that what is something which is acceptable in a society. We only are following the rat race. And giving one more example, you know, whenever I used to go for PTMs and I used to attend my, you know, daughter's PTM, and there the teacher used to talk about why, you know, your kid is, you know, maybe at the 7th position, 8th position. And I used to wear that at least they should tell some parent that even though your child is not doing so well in academics, but at the same time, your child is, you know, good in other, maybe I would say maybe has a strong value, or maybe knows, you know, how to behave in a class and all that. So I believe that, you know, it's not the teacher's role starts from the day when a small kid is entering into a kindergarten till they continue in their schools, colleges and all. And the next, you know, I would say that when there was this lockout period, Mahabharata and Ramayana was being played, and I somehow missed that when I was in young age and all. So I started watching this Mahabharata and all that very closely. And I really used to love the character of Drona, you know, because I used to see that he's the person behind Arjun, and because of Arjun that Mahabharata, definitely, you know, the Pandavas, Kauravas, we have won just because of Arjuna. But I could see the other side of it, that not only he had Arjun as a disciple, but he had Ashwathama also as a disciple, even though he was his own child. And he had, you know, Duryodhan also as his, you know, another disciple. So I believe that even if we create thousands of Arjunas around, but if we create one Duryodhan, or if we create one Ashwathama, and, you know, we've been blaming Ashwathama that why did he do that and all. Some way or the other, Drona had a very big role to play, you know, I mean, in creating those wrong seeds in his mind that, you know, why don't you be the part of the throne? Why don't you be the next king? And he could not play the role of a guru for his own child. So I mean, even if we create thousands of Arjunas in our life, but if we create one wrong character, one wrong personality, I think there the role, the justice of the role has not been done. And some way or the other, we have to keep then facing these Mahabharatas, which nowadays most of the media channels have also named discussion as Mahabharatas. So these are something which I thought I would share. The another thing which I believe in, that, you know, many times there was a WhatsApp message which I read, and it was like, you know, God is the biggest guru, and God is the one who teaches us what is good, what is bad, what are real values, what are bad values, you know, how should we be connected with the roots and all those things. And guru has been given a place next to God. So if I say what I have been telling myself is that you're already close to the God. And when you're close to the God, when you're teaching in a class, kahin na kahin aap us time pe bhagwan ka karya karte hote hain. You know, because God has been doing the same thing. You know, God has been teaching us all those kind of things. And when we are there in the class, some way or the other, we are performing some duties of a God. And if we do that in the right way, if we make changes in the lives of our students, I think we have won the battle, and all the teachers need to understand this. And another thing which I want to say is that it's not necessarily that you need to have a designation of a teacher being a teacher. Anybody in your life could be a teacher. Like, for example, my father was never a teacher. He had nothing to do with the teaching profession. But today, if I say who has been my teacher, my biggest teacher has been my father. And today, if I'm in this profession, it is because of him. So these are some of the thoughts, you know, which keep on coming in my mind, which keeps on telling me that what is the role of a good teacher. And time has come, we need to move from a good teacher to a great teacher. We have been talking about companies to move from good to great. But I think time has come, we understand what are the attributes, what are the parameters of being a great teacher. And today when I was looking at my WhatsApp, I got 183 messages from my old students. And, you know, I got so tired in replying to all the message. and I had tears in my eyes. There was a student who was a 2001 batch, and I thought, how could he remember me after so many years? And I cannot say that we are a great teacher, but this is, I would say, milestones which we need to achieve from time to time, and some way or the other, see ourselves as a great teacher. That is what my understanding on this auspicious day is. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to speak on this particular platform. And I really feel, you know, even if I'm talking right now, kahin na kahin hum Bhagwan ka karyakram kar rahe hain, or at this point in time, I'm doing some work which maybe God has been doing at his own place. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful words. We really appreciate it. Now, I would request Drishan Sharma to further take the event ahead.
Thank you so much, Navleen. Before taking a step further, we would like to wish once again all the faculty members present today a very happy Teachers' Day. We can't thank them enough for the support and guidance they have provided and making us ready to face the real world. Our heartfelt gratitude to all the teachers who are coping up with their academic schedule and responsibilities during the present situation. Despite working virtually, our teachers have been able to make our learnings impactful and enjoyable. At IBS, students undergo 14-week summer internship program from February to May, which gives them an edge over other B schools. During the internship tenure, students are exposed to the corporate world and seek opportunities to hone their skills and experience to enrich their career prospects. During the tenure of 3 months, students are guided and trained by the corporate mentors and faculty supervisors, providing holistic growth and development to inculcate the skills required to grow ahead in career. The summer internship program offers an opportunity to have real-world experience working with industry experts, corporate exposure, which gives them a glimpse of future which lies beyond, networking with different professionals working at various positions, and nurturing their professional skills such as time management and goal setting. The activities of summer internship program are undertaken by the internship cell at IBS Gurgaon, which comprises of the team of 28 student representatives headed by Dean Academics and senior faculty members. The internship cell aims to provide the best of the corporate opportunities to the junior batch. They bind the entire process from inviting the companies, handling the SIP processes under the guidance of faculty members, and recognizing the best internships. In the present time of online classes, internship cell organized lectures and panel discussions for the students to help them to cope up with the corporate world. Now I request Aradhita to please take over.
Thank you, Dushan. There could be no better occasion than Teachers' Day to launch the SIP brochure of 2021. Moving forward, on this auspicious occasion of Teachers' Day, we take this opportunity to unveil and launch the SIP brochure of the year and mark the beginning of Summer Internship Program 2021. The Summer Internship brochure brings to you detailed information about the student mix of class of 2022 and glimpse of endeavors undertaken by the internship cell, along with candid testimonials of batch of 2021. To launch the Summer Internship brochure, I would like to request our respected director, sir, Professor S.C. Sharma, our chief guest, Dr. Pawan Kumar Singh, sir, our Deputy Director of Placements, Deans, and all faculty members to join us for the unveiling of the SIP brochure. Now, I would like to request Sagar to unveil the SIP brochure. With unveiling of the brochure, we mark the commencement of the SIP season 2021. We now invite all our esteemed corporates to participate in our summer internship program, and we wish all the very best to the new batch. Now, I would like to request our Dean Academics and SIP Coordinator, Dr. Shalini Khandelwal Ma'am, to kindly propose the word of thanks.
Thank you so much, Aradhita. And thanks to all the faculty, students, staff, everybody present here to have joined us on this celebration of Teachers' Day 2020. I'm sure this Teachers' Day is different from our earlier celebrations. On campus, this would be a huge, glittering, and shining event with all the faculties, students around. Nevertheless, I think we have created a similar environment online, and thanks to everyone for making it a success. First and foremost, I would like to thank our chief guest, Professor Dr. Pawan Kumar Singh, sir, from Director MDI. He has been kind enough to accept our invitation and guide us on this auspicious day. And his 6 points and words of wisdom, I think, will be a lifelong learning torch for all of us. Whether it is our faculty members, our staff, our students, I think if we have understood these 6 points, there is no other stop on our development and growth towards a bright future. Thank you so much, sir. And your words of wisdom will inculcate the joy of living that you have been talking about. That is your favorite quote, and also the joy of learning that all our faculty members are endeavoring towards. Thanks to our director, sir, for guiding us, leading us during all times, specifically during tough times, when he asks us to be determined, to show the light to all our students, to continue to conduct the semester and with the same quality and impact for the last so many years. Thank you so much, sir. You have always been so kind and always been so firm to make us perform our roles to our best capabilities. Thank you, sir, for being there. Thanks to our Deputy Director Placements, Dr. Rana, and our Dean Examinations, Professor Venkat Raman, for all your support and all your cooperation in all the academic activities, co-curricular activities on the campus, so that our students get the dream jobs, so that our students land in the right careers and lifelong remain our brand ambassadors. And before I would go to our faculty, I would like to thank our students. Without students, there are no faculties, definitely. All our students have shown their enthusiasm, their eagerness to learn, have been with us, have understood the situations, have understood the time. And believe me, I'm very much happy and encouraged to see their participation in the classes and out of the classes in all our events and activities. Today's event also, thanks to the alumni relations cell, a big clap for them under the guidance of Professor Devika, and to the internship cell, another big clap to them under the guidance of the internship faculty. They have done a marvelous job. We are not there face to face with them to guide them on every step, but they have assumed this leadership role. And I think every activity on campus has been undertaken as per schedule. I would like to inform Director MDI, Professor Singh, sir, that we have kept up with our schedules, whether it is our classroom teaching, whether it is our evaluations, our midterm exams, our end-term exams, our summer internship program, our placement program, preparedness for placement. Everything is being done on schedule, as is mentioned in the student handbook, which was printed much before the corona pandemic struck over. So that is possible only with the support and with the enthusiasm of the students. And I can see that joy on their faces. I'm very happy you are all here to show your gratitude to your teachers. And last but not the least, A very big thank you to all the faculty members and staff members present here. We are all teachers. We say we learn from each other, right? And the way we have learned from each other in the 5 years can be a very successful case study, believe me. You know, how we have learned new methods of teaching online, new technologies, and every faculty, like Professor Singh was mentioning, that we should be good in mathematical skills and language skills. Now it has become so imperative for all of us to be excellent in digital skills. And not all of us have had that kind of inclination, right? But we all came together and we all have seen that these things happen uninterrupted. And the attendance of students in the class is much better than the physical classrooms on campus. So that is again an encouragement. Thanks to all the faculty members, to all the staff running behind the scenes, taking the role of Zoom administrators for all activities and events, and seeing that the semester is smoothly progressing forward. And I'm sure with this support and coordination, what IBS is known for, you know, the academic rigor, and the strong industry-focused curriculum and industry-oriented teaching methodologies, we would do wonders even for the batch of 2022 and the batch of 2021 presently with us. So with those words, I would like to again thank everybody and congratulate everybody for the achievements. And I'm sure we will continue to do our best in the times to come. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here and being there across all times. Thank you so much. So now I would like to call upon all the faculty members as well as staff members present here to put on their videos if possible, so that we can save the memories of today's event and that can be memorable event for all of us, I would say. So all the teachers and all the staff members can please put on their videos. We'll take a picture. Aradhita, will you do it?
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Yeah. So maybe you will have to take pictures screen by screen, so you can do that now.
All right.
Nita Mishra, ma'am, you can help her.
Done, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much. So thank you, everyone, once again. Now over to Professor Devika, the coordinator of Alumni Relations Cell.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, everyone, for being a part of this program. And thank you, Pavan, sir. Thank you, Director, sir. Thank you, all the faculty members. I really want to thank the staff members as well and the students who actually make us the, you know, the special one today. And thank you, everyone. So with this, we would like to end the event. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So we can end the meeting now, Professor Devika.
I think she has left.
Okay. So we have stayed here. So let's take a picture of all of us.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, we could just take a picture. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. I shall leave, you know, I am still on.
Okay.
Be here for some time. Le lo ek picture, Aradhita, or who is taking?
We are just doing.
Oh, it's going on Facebook. Vinita Mishra, ma'am, we can now discontinue the recording also.
I'm a very happy Teachers' Day from our side.
Thank you so much.
For all the faculties.
Happy Teachers' Day.
Happy
Teachers' Day. It was a very nice event. Organized very, nicely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
the brochure has come out really well. Very nice.
Thanks to the team, ma'am.
Yeah. So shall we now close it?
Sure, ma'am.
All the best. All the best.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Bye.
Yeah.
Please end the session. Go ahead, ma'am.
Hello. Host, please end the meeting. Hello.
I would request the room admin to please end the session.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, I'm not the host.
You are the host now, sir. Who is the host?
No, ma'am, I am co-host. Host is someone else. Ten number to koi hai.
Gurgaon 11-10 is the host. Please, whoever is handling Gurgaon 11-10. Please end the meeting.
Please end the meeting. Gurgaon 11-10, please.
Anurag, sir, please find out.
I'm calling to Mr. Pandey.
Okay, sir, please meeting end.